ODMS is a lot more advanced than comparison test standard release 2, with functionality such as central management and advanced voice recognition settings. We will start by comparing some of the main settings for the standard release 2 dictation module and the ODMS dictation module. Within the folder design section for standard release 2, it is possible to rename folders, change the folder path, and set the auto download option. Under workflow, you have some general settings such as choosing what happens when files are deleted, synchronizing the date and time of the PC to a connected device, and the refresh interval for software folders. You also have the delete option, which automatically removes files from the voice recorder once they are successfully downloaded into the software. There are also some basic voice recognition settings. In the user settings, you have an option for language, hotkeys, and playback settings. Under the device tab, you can change the author ID of a device as well as renaming the device folders. There are some other settings relating to the recording mode of the device and display settings. You can also change the settings for the function buttons. In the update section, you have the ability to change the interval at which the software checks for software and firmware updates, as well as being able to configure proxy server settings. Now we will go through some of the options for the ODMS dictation module. Already we can see that there are so many more options available for ODMS. In the folder design section, it is possible to change folder names, folder paths, and set encryption for the software folders. There are also a lot more actions to automate processes such as automatic download, automatic convert, and automatic email. There is a backup setting. This ensures that for every dictation that is successfully downloaded, there is a copy in the backup folder. The clean option can be enabled to automatically remove files from this folder after a period of time. The general section under the workflow tab is fairly similar to the standard software. You have some additional settings such as the DSS Classic, which just ensures backwards compatibility with older versions of software, and the file name resolution in case there are multiple files with the same name. In the download section, as well as the delete setting, there are other download options such as prompt for job data every time a file is downloaded. This allows you to enter additional information for recordings at the point of download. There is also an advanced download setting. This can be customized so that all dictations are downloaded into a specific folder, or they are routed to different folders based on the author ID or work type ID of the dictation. The ODMS dictation module supports background and real-time voice recognition. Settings related to voice recognition can be found in the workflow section. The document receive function automatically imports transcribed documents received via email or FTP into the dictation module's document tray folder to manage documents. For this function to work, you must have an email or FTP profile configured within the software. The software can also be set to notify you when a new document has arrived. The user settings can be configured to the same extent as the standard release 2 software. With ODMS, it is possible to set up an email or FTP profile to send dictations directly from the ODMS dictation module. Under the device section, it is possible to configure basic settings such as power save and display settings, through to more advanced settings such as adding a PIN code to the device and encryption. In the updates section, you can specify how regularly the software checks for updates. This option is currently greyed out as ODMS is installed in workgroup mode. Now we will compare the settings for the standard release 2 transcription module and the ODMS transcription module. The folder settings for the standard release 2 transcription module are almost exactly the same as the standard release 2 dictation module. The only difference is, with the dictation module you have the recording folder for dictations that are recorded directly to the PC, whereas the transcription module has a finished folder for dictations that are marked as transcription finished. There is also a transcriptionist tray folder which allows the user to view all dictations from the folders above. The workflow section is also almost the same as the dictation module, but you have an additional option whereby the software can automatically open a word processor when you start transcribing a file. Under the user settings, you have the playback control options. Here you can configure settings such as the auto backspace and winding speed. The auto backspace feature determines how far to rewind a dictation when the play pedal is released during transcription. The winding speed allows you to change the speed at which the software will rewind into a dictation. You also have the ability to change options relating to the transcribe bar. Here you can configure the transcribe bar to count up or down and which buttons are shown on the bar. Within the device section for standard release 2, you can change the settings for the RS27 and RS28 foot pedal. Under the update section, you can specify how often the software checks for updates and you can configure proxy server settings. We will now go through some of the option settings for the ODMS transcription module. The folder settings for the ODMS transcription module are not too dissimilar from the ODMS dictation module folder settings. Rather than the automatic clean feature, you can set the software to notify for new dictations in specific folders. There are also a few more folders in the transcription module, such as a transcriptionist tray. Once again, the transcriptionist tray is a summary of all the files from the folders above. The workflow section is also quite similar to the ODMS dictation module, but there are some notable settings. The dictation receive function automatically imports dictations received via email or FTP. For this function to work, you must have an email or FTP profile configured within the software. The software can be set to notify users when new dictations have been received. Dictations received via email or FTP can be routed to specific folders based on routing rules. Under the routing option, you can also set up a document return function. This will automatically send the document to the sender once transcription is completed. The ODMS transcription module supports background voice recognition and can cater for up to 10 separate authors, each with their own Dragon Naturally Speaking profile. Settings related to voice recognition can be configured in the workflow section. As well as being able to open a word processor when a user starts transcribing a file, it is also possible to open a specific document template based on the author ID and worktype ID of a dictation. By default, the automatic collection function will automatically move files that are marked as transcription finished to the finished folder. Rules can be set to move finished dictations to specific folders based on their author IDs and worktype IDs. The user settings for the ODMS transcription module are the same as those for the standard Release 2 transcription module. You can set up an email or FTP profile to receive dictations directly into the ODMS transcription module. In the device section, you can change the settings for an RS32 hand controller and for the RS31, RS28 and RS27 foot pedals. In the updates section, you can specify how regularly the software checks for updates. This option is currently greyed out as ODMS is installed in workgroup mode. In this example, I have set Standard Release 2 to automatically download files to a shared network location and to automatically delete the files from the voice recorder. I've disabled folders B to G and have set an author ID and renamed a folder on the device. The dictation has downloaded and I'm going to send it to voice recognition. Follow the prompt to start transcribing the file. Click Transcribe. Once transcription is complete, Dragon will prompt to choose what to do with the text. I've chosen to open the file using DragonPad. From here, you can play the file back and make changes to the text. As mentioned, central management is possible with ODMS. Here I am using the System Configuration program to configure a user. The settings that have been configured are a mapped folder, automatic email, voice recognition, an author ID, work type IDs, and advanced download routing. The dictations have downloaded based on the routing rules. There are some dictations in the shared typing pool folder, some downloaded to the email folder and are now in the outbox sending, a few dictations downloaded to the voice recognition folder and have been added to the voice recognition queue, and there are some dictations in the local My Recordings folder. The files that were added to the queue are now being transcribed. This process is known as background voice recognition. Once complete, you can open the document in the text correction window. In the text correction window, correct any words that Dragon may have transcribed incorrectly. Mark the file as finished once complete. Now we will demonstrate real-time voice recognition. The real-time voice recognition feature is most similar to using a USB microphone with Dragon Naturally Speaking's Dragon Pad. It features a text-based window in which a user can dictate and see their audio being transcribed while they speak. The window features playback controls, text editing facilities, and a toolbar to save and export the dictation. I will now save the audio file and export the document. Once the files have been completed and corrected, the finished documents will become available. The files will appear within the My Documents folder in the folder tree on the left side of the window. We have separate guides on the central admin components and the voice recognition settings.